codes that satisfy the prefix property are always uniquely decodable. And instantaneously decodable. In other words, I encode my string of original letters uniquely, and as those original letters occur, or as a complete code word appears, I can immediately decode it and say what it is. And that's because no other code word begins with any other code word, if I see a complete word, that must be the only way that can possibly appear. So in other words, if I see 1, 0, the only way that could have happened is if a B was sent. So immediately I can cut that off and say that's definitely a B. Whereas the other way, remember I had 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. If I see 0, 1, which is a complete B, it could be part of a C. So that's an annoying thing that we avoid with the prefix property. Okay, so there is, it turns out that this might seem surprising, but it is possible to design. This is a constraint. This prefix property. It seems like this should cost you something, but in fact, no. It is possible to design an entropy achieving code that obeys the prefix property, and the way to design one is called the Huffman procedure. Then what we do is we take the bottom two letters, the lowest two letters, and assign 0 to 1 and 1 to the other. Then we combine letters into a super letter. Same order are 1/2, This is in fact already sorted in decreasing order, so let's just write that down. A, B, C, D. So we'll write it as a vertical list. I'm going to rank the probabilities beside them. So what do? We combine, we take the lowest two letters. Assign 0 to one and 1 to the other. Okay, so it doesn't matter which one. And then we combine them into a super letter, CD. CD, the event CD is that either C or D happens. What's the probability of CD?
1/4.
So it's 1/4. It's just the sum of these two probabilities. So, and then we start over. So what do we have? We have 1/2, 1/4, and 1/4. Okay, these are already sorted in decreasing order. The bottom two letters are B and CD. So we can combine those together. Assign a 0 to 1 and a 1 to the other. End up with BCD. So the super event BCD, what's its probability?
1/2.
It's 1/4 plus 1/4. And A. This is already in decreasing order. So we combine these, assign a 0 to 1 and a 1 to the other. And we end up with ABCD. And because we only have a single event left, we're done. So what is the code word? Well, basically, you follow the path. Picking up the binary digit, picking up bits as you go. So, start here and go through one. Excuse me. So let's write the code word for A, B, C, and D. So these are elements X and the corresponding code word. So A, we end up here. The only bit that we had on that path was 0. The code word for A is 0. For B, start here, pick up a 1 there, and then this is still a super event, so we have to split it some more. So B goes to here, that's where B is, and I pick up a 0. C, I go here, I pick up a 1. I go here, I pick up another 1. And I end up here with a 0. And D, I pick up a 1. I pick up another 1. And I end up with a third 1 here. So there's your Hoffman code.